Hi, it's Lily Amanda for Portrait Creatives. In this video, we are going to talk about how to remove glasses glare or reflections in Photoshop. Glasses glare or reflection are not always easy to clean up. In fact, they can be really tricky and difficult to do. And not all the glasses reflection is able to rescue. So I would highly suggest you to use the right lighting to be able to achieve the best results. Because after all, Photoshop is a software to enhance and sometimes fix some problems. But I always want to shoot the images as good as possible in camera instead of using Photoshop to fix problems. Glasses glare and reflection usually caused by a light in front of just hit on the glass directly. If it is higher, if it's lower, it's not going to affect the glasses. So only when the light source is hit on the glass directly, okay? That's the principle. So when you're doing studio work, I would highly suggest you just move the light away from the direction of the glasses. For example, if a glass is here, right? And you move the light to the sideway or on the top, as long as the light is not directly pointed at the glasses, it won't cause a reflection. So what I do in studio is I will place the light over here on one side, it doesn't matter which side, and the other side I will have a reflector. So in this way, I am not hitting any of the light directly on the glasses. And the other setup is I will raise the light like quite high above the glasses. In this way, I will not hit the glasses directly as well, and I will have a fill underneath. In this way, I will have enough light, but no light will cause the reflection on the glasses, and that's the best way. And the other best way is have non-glare glasses, which is a bit difficult because not all of your clients will have that type of glasses. Okay, so just bear in mind, first thing is to correct the lighting in camera when you shoot, so you don't have to do this step in Photoshop. Because it is time consuming if you have like loads of photos you have to retouch for the glasses glare. If one is okay, but if you have more, then it's going to take a lot of time. So I highly suggest you to do it in camera, not in Photoshop. So what happens if you do an outdoor portrait? It's the same. If you're having your subject facing in the light directly, you will definitely have the glare. If you can bring your subject to face something that is not directly bright light, it's on the side or just on the top, that will work as well. But in case you accidentally need to fix this problem, and I have a solution for you, so let me take you into Photoshop. So let's have a look at this image. I like this natural look of the image. Even with some glasses glare on her glasses, I don't mind that at all because it looks natural and it has a kind of feel and mood in it. But if you want to remove it, let me show you how to do it. There are two things to consider. One is the object reflect on the glasses. The other one is the color. So we're going to take care of them separately. So first of all, I want to take off the color, like the greenish color of the reflection first. And then the second step is going to remove all those reflection. So first thing is I would just use a new layer. Let me go to a new layer here, click here, okay? And then I'm going to zoom in, have a look at this image, and I would just use brush. Brush is B, brush B, and then I'll just size down a little bit, and remember to use a soft brush, okay? And I will sample the color. I just hit enter, so my setting is set. Okay, so I'm going to select the color nearby this greenish reflection, and I'm just gonna paint over it. And here is black, I'm gonna paint over like this. Okay, so I'm gonna paint a little bit, this too much. Paint a little bit this way, okay? And here I have to zoom in a little bit more because you can see there's some streaky green tone there. So I'm going to just do this, okay? Don't worry about too much about the details. I am just going to do this one. Okay, like this, go over, trying to select a tone without the green in it. This one has to go over here a little bit, and then I'm gonna just do it over here. And this one is a lighter tone, so perhaps I'll just select over here like this. And here, I'm gonna zoom in even more because I will take out this green tone, so I'm gonna mask. So I'm going to select this dark area and then just paint over it. And this one, I'm going to select over here and paint over this area. Okay, I'm just doing one side so you can see difference. I'm going to just apply a little bit Gaussian blur to blend all the edges in. Okay, so here, filter, blur, Gaussian blur. So let me see, maybe 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay, that's good. So click OK. And I'm going to change to color blending mode. So that's the color you get. You can see before and after. So the green tone is gone. And I'll do the same the other side. So you can see what I do again. I can most probably do on the same layer. I'm going to change back to normal and then sample here. You could, I use bigger brush so it's faster. Okay, so here, let me just go over. I'm going to sample this color. Like I will sample the closest color for, okay, here's for more realistic look. Okay, and let me just paint over here. Use this one and paint over here. Here has a little bit greenish tone. Here, I'm going to use here. Paint over here. Here and over here. And just paint a little bit above here. Okay, so that looks quite good. And I'm going in to do the eyes. The lashes here. I sample the color over here. Just a dark tone area. This is her eyeliner. And here I'm going to choose a tone which is not green. So which part? This part maybe. Okay, so I can just brush over. And then here, that's the tone, like this. You just paint it over like that. So it's no green tone here. Okay, so here's has a little bit, so I'm gonna paint over a little bit here. Just paint over to get rid of all the green tone. Okay, so I think about it. I am going to change it to color. So the color is gone, all the green tone is gone. Let me see here. This is okay. So I'm going to use another layer. Oh, now I add another new layer. I go to clone stamp tool and then I change my brush to about 20%. Okay, right. Sample this area over here and then I'm just going to sort of brush them. I resample again and brush them up. Sample again, brush them down. I sample here and brush them down like that. I think I would change the opacity a little bit higher to 40% so I can make quicker of the progress. Okay, so you see I'm cloning. Keep sampling and cloning the area. Okay, so just blend everything together. And here also, I'm gonna just blend it carefully over here and here. I'm just going to blend them together. I'm going to use a smaller brush, perhaps like this. Just blend them all together. I use a lower opacity because that would help me to blend them together better. Don't worry about the line because we're going to recreate these. Okay, so that looks okay. Let me see. Yep, that looks okay. Perhaps just a little bit here. So what I'm going to do is actually I'm just going to sample here. just break the pattern of the reflection, and then it will look much more natural. Let me just come out here so it looks way better, right? Just clone a little bit here. Okay, but we have to draw this line back. So I am going to add another layer, and then I use brush tool B, and I'm gonna sample this color. I think it's this one or this one, something darker perhaps, this one. And then I'm just gonna paint it back like this. I think it's not dark enough. I want to find something a little bit darker. Maybe this one, that's too dark. Let me just try this one. Okay, that's better. So I'll just carefully draw it back like this. Okay, zoom out, and then I'm going to filter blur, Gaussian blur. Just blur a little bit, maybe one or two would be enough. Two, okay, so I think that looks quite natural. I'm going to lower the opacity, maybe 80% would be enough, or maybe 70, you can see before and after. Okay, that looks natural. You compare to the other side, it looks pretty natural, right? So one side of the job is done, and let me see. This is the green, this is the clone. I'm going to name this clone. Okay, and then I see in here it's not so blended, so I'm going to do it again. Just going to select sample, use my clone stamp tool at 40%. I'm going to sample over here and just go over so it will look more blended here. Okay, so that's the result. And another thing is I would add some grain to make it look natural, okay? Because you will see like this place are over smoothed and there's no details at all. And other side of area, they all have grain. So I'm gonna add a grain back. So noise, add noise. And here is, let's see. That looks pretty good. Let me just zoom. Oh, that's too much. So I have Gaussian blur, and also I uncheck the monochromatic because you can see this has got multiple different color of the grain. So that's what I'm going for as well. So let's have a look. Maybe about here, maybe a bit more. Just compare what they already have over here. Okay, let me see, 5%. Maybe a little bit more. 6, 7. Yeah, that looks, I think 5 will be good. Okay, so I'll click OK. And you can zoom out. This is before, this is after. So that looks tons better, right? And it's the same with the other side. And you can also see the details over here. Like for example, here, I will just sample over here and clone over, right? And then this time we use 100% because I need the dark color coming through, okay? So there you are. And I just demonstrate one side for you. And the other side you can use it as homework. So before and after. And then because here is a bit brighter, I might, okay, let me see before and after. So here I might want to darken it to make it look even more natural. So I'm going to use adjustment layer and curves. And then I'm gonna click this finger tool. And then I'm gonna just move it down a little bit. And then come on I to invert the mask because I only want to paint over this area to affect this area. Okay, so that looks tons better, right? And that's before. That's after. You can zoom out to see. That's before, that's after. So this is the tutorial today. It is not an easy fix, you can see. It really does take time to make it look perfect. Because of that reason, I will always try to do it in camera. So I don't have to worry about this problem in Photoshop. I hope you find this video helpful, get some value out of this demonstration. We will be uploading more helpful tutorials, so do subscribe to our channel so you won't miss out any. And I'll see you in the next video.